in the previous time, we talk about some glad tidings about Muhammad Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam in their holy book. So we studied two chapters or books. That's book of Daniel and book of the Song of Solomon. Song of Solomon mentioned the name of Muhammad Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam, while book of Daniel mentioned the time that his kingdom will appear. Muhammad in the first chapter, and in the second chapter that his kingdom will appear 1260 years after the kingdom of Nebuchadnezzar, the Babylonians in Iraq. Now, this chapter or book I'm talking about is the book of Genesis. This is the first book of the five books of Moses. The five books of Moses, the other name for it is Torah. Torah are five books, yani خمسة سور. To make it easy for you. هذه هي التوراة. The first of them is Genesis. Genesis means التكوين. It talks about creation of the world and about the creation of the nation of Israel. It talks about Abraham and his two sons, Ishmael and Isaac, then Jacob, son of Isaac, then the 10 tribes. One of them is Joseph, Yusuf alayhi salam. Then 200 years in Egypt. After that, Moses, Aaron, Musa wa Harun. Then Joshua. After that, 430 years comes the golden era of the Israelites, of children of Israel, is the Solomon, David, Shaul, Talut, Wadawud, and Suleiman. The three kings, they call them the three kings, the kings. Then after that, the division, after the death of Solomon, the division into two kingdoms, Samaria and Judea. Samaria and Judea. Samaria, the capital was, يلا في فلسطينيين هنا عاصمة السامرة مش كانت اللي اسمها السامرة الآن ناس يسموها السامرة نابلس and the Judea that is اليهودية اللي عاصمتها القدس. The division into Samaria and Judea after Solomon into two kingdoms. One kingdom was unbelievers. They worshipped the golden calf. Do you remember the golden calf? Al-Ajl al-Dahabi. Who the first one to advent this one? Samari. So that they called themselves Samariyun, the Samaria. Or Israel. Kingdom of Israel or Samaria. After Solomon, they changed their religion into pagans. The Israelites are 12 tribes, isn't it?
Yes.
12. 10 of them, after Solomon, they changed into pagans. Irtidad, Ridda. They changed to unbelievers, to be unbelievers. Only two tribes, they continue to be believers. They call them the Judea, Al-Yahud. 200 years after that event of division, the Israel, Kingdom of Israel, the unbelievers, have been attacked by Sargon. Sargon is a a leader of Iraq. He came from that part of the world. They call it Ashuriyim, Assyrian. He killed most of them, and he took the others to captivity. And they disappeared, the 10 tribes. Now, if you want to meet one of them, you'll not be able. Why? They disappeared. They dissolved in Iraq and Iran. And nobody knows. And they don't know themselves that they belong to Israelite. They don't know. Now, in Israel, they start to search for them by DNA investigation. They want to see who are they. Are they somebody? Some said they are the Pashto people in Afghanistan. Some said no, they are the Brahma in India. Some said no, they are the Flash in Africa. Some they said no, they are in the South Africa. Some said they are the Berber in North Africa. They don't know. I know. They are Iraqi and Iranian, they are Muslims. But they don't know that their ancestors have been Jewish. Alhamdulillah, now they are Muslims and they don't know that they belong to that genealogy. By logic, the problems that we have now is from those two tribes. Alhamdulillah, if they continue to be 12, we have a lot of problems. But now you know that there is the 13th tribe. The tribe number 13. Do you know who are they? Anybody read about it? The 13th tribe. Those are not sons of Jacob. ليسوا من بني إسرائيل. A new nation introduced themselves to the Jewish creed. They don't belong to it. Who are they? They call them the Khazar, Al-Khazar, the Ashkenazi people. They are Europeans. They have blue eyes. They are white. They have fair hair. Huh? Most of the Israeli people now, the leaders, most of them, they came from Poland and from the west of Europe, East Europe. They are not sons or children of Israel. They claim this. No, they are not. Do you know that there in the world now there is 15 million Jewish. 15 million Yehudi. 5 in Israel, 5 in United States and Europe, and 5 in Russia. Only. They are still minority. 85% of those 15 million are Ashkenazi, are non-Israelites. And you know, I'm a surgeon. And you know who is a surgeon? Do you know, understand what do you mean by a surgeon? Jarrah. The surgeon is a person who cuts people, like a butcher. But the butcher does not stitch them back. We put some stitches. So I'm a doctor, and when we study some diseases, we find that we and the Jewish people are similar in being subjected to some type of diseases. Except the Ashkenazi, no. The Ashkenazi has different type of diseases. They have different. So we and the 15% people of Jewish, we are similar in DNA, in genes. Because their father is Isaac, and our father is Ishmael, and they are brothers. Brothers. Different mothers, but the same father. So logical that we have the same character, the same diseases. But the Ashkenazi, no. The Ashkenazi are not they don't belong to our genes. They are different people. Now, this is the story of Abraham when he went to Egypt. Do you remember this story from Islamic literature? Yeah. Abraham went to Egypt. The Pharaoh, Pharaoh, gave as a gift. I don't want to go too deep to that story. Yeah, I know that it is a very important story. Very, very important. But I will not go to that because it's not my scope of the lecture, my lecture scope. But the result of this story, he gave to her, to Sarah, he gave her a gift, a servant, female servant, Hagar, Hajar. Hagar was a servant given to Sarah. There is a story behind that. I will not go to that story. After a period of time, Sarah said to Abraham, Abraham, you are now old man. I cannot give birth to children, infertile. So why don't you marry Hagar? He married her. She became pregnant, and the baby was Ishmael. See what this book said about Ishmael. Said a lot of things. This book, their book, says things about Ishmael, that he is a blessed person. Before the mention of Isaac, before Isaac was mentioned, the name mentioned Isaac, 11 times the name of Ishmael was mentioned with blessings. Was mentioned with blessings. So he is a blessed person in their own book. See, this is one of the blessings. And as for Ishmael, this is God talking to Abraham. God said to Abraham, as for Ishmael, I have given ear to you. I listened to you. Truly, I have given him my blessings, and I will make him fertile and give him a great increase. He will be the father of 12 chiefs, and I will make him a great nation. So if you ask any Jewish or Christian man about Arab, what do you think about Arab in your book? He will say, well, they are blessed persons. They are a blessed nation. He cannot deny that because it is mentioned 11 times before the appearance of their grandfather named Isaac. 11 times. From where I brought this 11 number? Number 11. From their own scholars. They calculated for me. I did check after them. I found that, yes, this is the truth. 11 times. So Ishmael was a blessed person. And he will be a great nation. They cannot deny this. they said, some of their scholars, they said, no. Yes, he's a blessed person, but the covenant, the covenant, is not for Ishmael, it's for Isaac. And the signature of the covenant is the circumcision. Circumcision is, in their book, is the sign or the signature of God on the flesh of human being. This is what they say. Look what they say. And Abraham took Ishmael, his son, and all whose birth had taken place in his house, and all his servants whom he had made, his for a price, every male of his house, and on that very day he gave them circumcision in the flesh of their private parts, as God had said to him. So even Ishmael here is included in the covenant. They cannot deny that. They will try to escape, but there is no escape for them from their own book. Use this, please, to prove to them that Muhammad is a prophet of a great nation according to their book. Deuteronomy. Deuteronomy, this is another book, book number two, of Moses, of Torah. What do we mean by Deuteronomy? It means the law. The law means Sharia, al-Qanun. Okay? And there, the law of Moses was mentioned. In this book, what did it say? The Lord, thy God, yani your God, will raise up unto thee for them a prophet from the midst of thee, of thy brethren. Yani, it's an old English, huh? Like unto me, unto him you shall hearken. Yani, Moses is talking to Bani Israel, to children of Israel, to Israelites. ممكن تقول children of Israel, ممكن تقول Israelite. The same in English is okay. Moses said, the Lord, your God, will raise up for you a prophet from your brothers. To him you shall hear. Yani, you have to listen to him. Who are the brothers of the Jewish people? Ismailites. So it is clear, there is an evidence here against them to prove that Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam, and then ask anybody, Ishmaelites, did any prophet came from Ishmaelites, yani Abna Ismail, Ishmael children, except Muhammad? Only Muhammad. Nobody claimed that. I will raise them, God talking to Musa, to Moses. I will raise them up a prophet from among their brothers, like unto thee, yani like you, and will put my words in his mouth, and he shall speak unto them all that I shall command him. This means that the coming prophet from the brothers will not be, cannot read or write. I put my words in his mouth. What ayah in the Quran means this? وَمَا يَنْتَقُوا عَلْ هَوَى يَسْ إِنَّ عَلَيْنَا Now, this is the blessings, هذه البركات, which Moses, the man of God, gave to the children of Israel before his death. هذه البركات التي قالها موسى لقومه قبل أن يموت. He said, the Lord came from Sinai, جاء الرب من سيناء, dawning on them from سعير, shining out from the Mount Paran. جاء الرب من سيناء وأضاء لهم أو أشرق لهم من سعير فلسطين shining out وتلألأ from the Mount Paran, Paran مكة. Okay? Coming from Mirabath Kadesh, عشرات الألوف من القديسين. From his right hand went flames of fire وعلى يمينه أضاء نور. His wrath made waste the peoples. All his holy ones are at his hand. They go at his feet. They are lifted up on his wings. Did this remind you something in Quran? I will read it back to you again. جاء الرب من سيناء وأضاء لهم من سعير من فلسطين وتلألأ لهم من مكة. The Lord came from Sinai, dawning on them from Seir, shining out from the Mount Paran. Who remembers this in Quran? Wattini was Zaytun. Is Seir? Seir is Wattini was Zaytun, that's Palestine. وطور سينين سيناء وهذا البلد الأمين مكة. See, so here in this verse it said clearly that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala sent three messengers, one from Sina, one from Palestine, and one from Mecca: Moses, Jesus, then Muhammad. Okay, and this mirabat means asharat, asharat alaf. Qaddis اللي هم إيش فتحوا معاه مكة, فتح مكة. When they captured Mecca, they have been 10,000 holy ones, that's Sahaba. So just a quick revision. Yeah? The first book we studied was Sing of the Songs, or Song of Solomon. The name was mentioned clearly. Then the second book we studied was Daniel. Daniel talked about the period between Nebuchadnezzar and Muhammad, Kingdom of Islam. What was the period? 1260 years, lunar. Then the chapter of Genesis talked about Ishmael, described him as a blessed person, will be a father of 12 tribes, and will produce a very great nation. Okay? Deuteronomy book, the book of Deuteronomy, said, Moses said, and God said, there is a promise to Israelites that from their brothers, God will send a prophet that cannot read, a prophet that will come from Mecca, a prophet that will be accompanied by 10,000 of the holy people. Collect it together, put the pieces together. It cannot fit anybody except Muhammad صلى الله عليه وسلم. Isaiah. Well, the chapter or book of Isaiah is a very big book. And it is very clear in describing Muhammad صلى الله عليه وسلم. Not by the name, but by a lot of description. Do you know Medina al-Munawwara? Anybody is living there, was living there before? Anybody knows Medina very nicely? I will ask him about some area in Medina. Nobody. Imagine this is the mosque. Okay? I am praying now in the mosque. There is two mountains, one mountain, a big mountain to my left hand. That is Uhud. And there is a big mountain there in my right side. What is the name of the mountain in the right side? Salah. S-E-L-A. Or S-A-L-A. Salah. Or Salah. Okay? Near to Salah, there was a place called Al-Wada'. Al-Wada' is a place near to Salah. And there the women and children of Al-Ansar, the people of Medina, they were there waiting for Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. When they saw him, they start singing. Singing what? طلع البدر عليه. Okay? One year after that event, you will be surprised if I show you the, this bio in this book, the name of the mountain, Sila, and this song that they will sing for him, near to the Mount Sila, by name. And 1 year after that, do you know what happened after Al-Hijra, 1 year? Badr battle. And you know Quraysh, their name was Qidar, Al-Qidar. Qidar is son of Ishmael. Who said that Qidar is son of Ishmael? This book, their book. And we agree, as Arabs, as Muslims, we agree that Qidar is grandfather of Quraysh, yes. After 1 year of his hijra, Qidar came to fight him. And he was the winner over them, and he killed most of their princes, their chiefs. He killed 70 of them. This is also mentioned here. After 1 year, all the glory of Qidar will finish, and all their princes shall be killed. This is Isaiah chapter. What else? It mentioned the Hijra itself. Those people who are escaping from Qidar to Sala. Please, people of Tema. Tema is near to Medina and was inhabited by children of Israel. All children of Israel living in caravans, mustamarat, yani, near to Tema. Meet, please, go and help those who escape from Qidar. Give them bread, give them water, and help them. But they don't listen. Do you know the story of Zainab bint Huyay? Safiya bint Huyay, Umm al-Mu'mineen, radiallahu anha. You know how she embraced Islam? She said she was a lovely girl. And her father was fond of her. He always liked to carry her and kiss her and hug her. She was very lovely and very clever. But his brother is more close to her than her father, her uncle also. So the uncle and the father, they liked her too much. They loved her too much. One day when Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam came to Medina, and then her father, as a chief of the tribe, and her uncle, they went to meet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam. They met him and then they came back. So when she saw them going to the door, she jumped in front of them. Hey! Nobody take care of her. Nobody take notice of her. They are another world. So she kept silent. And she sat with them, listening to them, what's happening. So her father said to the uncle, Huyay said to Yasir, Yasir, is he the one? He said, he is the one. Oh, Yasir, are you sure? 100% sure. Then Yasir said to Huyay, is he the one? Said he, so are you sure? Yes, he's sure. And Safiya, Umm al-Mu'mineen, radiallahu anha, was listening to them, this conversation. Then at the end, he said to him, okay, Yasir, what shall we do? He said, well, I will be his enemy till my death, till the last moment of my life. He is not Isaac's children. He's not from the bloodline of Isaac. Don't want him. Yeah. At that time, Safiya said, I embraced Islam. I knew that Muhammad is the true prophet. And after Fath Khaybar, she was married and her husband was killed in the battle. And then Rasul Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam, she was a servant, yani slave to him. So he said to her, Safiya, your father is Huyayn, he's the chief of Israel. I will give you a choice. If you want to be free, I will let you go. If you want to marry me, it's up to you. She said, well, I will tell you a story, then you decide. I saw a dream, a vision. I saw the moon going out from Medina, then went to the heavens, then descended, then it comes to my chest. This is Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam. And I will tell you another story. When my father and my uncle saw you first, at the time I embraced Islam. I know that you are the prophet. This is Umm al-Mu'mineen. Safiya describing what her father, the chief of his children of Israel at that time. They did not listen to their book. It's jealousy. قل إن الفضل بيد الله يؤتيه من يشاء والله ذو الفضل العظيم يختص برحمته من يشاء. Okay, so Isaiah, chapter of Isaiah also mentioned captured of Mecca by 10,000 holy ones at Fath Mecca. Chapter of Isaiah also mentioned that the kingdom of God after Muhammad will go to Palestine and will conquer Palestine to the end of the world. Also, it mentioned that Islam or the kingdom of God will go to Iraq, to Babel, then it will conquer Iraq to the end of the days. This is all mentioned in chapter of Isaiah. I wonder, do you like to study the text? Or I leave it to you if you have a flash memory or something, because we have a lot of things to say about the Old Testament. We have to jump to the New Testament, I mean. For what do you like? Shall we go through the text?
Yes.
Okay. So the why I use this one, because this book said that the kingdom of God soldiers will use camels in their battles. Is there any kingdom other than Muslims using camels in their no. It's only Muslims. It's only Arab. See my servant, whom I am supporting, my loved one, in whom I take delight. I have put my spirit on him. He will give the knowledge of the true God to the nations. Yani, the prophets described here, he will be victorious over nations because he will transfer this knowledge to the nations. Christians said, if you give them this text, if you give them this Nas text, they will say, no, this is Jesus. And the nations, the Gentiles, okay? So this is describing Jesus. The dad said, okay, I accept. I like it, he said. But don't retrieve. لا تتراجع. Okay, agree? He said, agree, yeah. He said, okay. So Jesus is his servant. His abd. And we said his son. So there is no escape for them from this text. I am the Lord, and Allah. That is my name, وهذا اسمي. I will not give my glory to another. لن أعطي مجدي للآخرين. Or my praise to pictured images. ولا مجدي للمنحوتات أو للأصنام. هل هذا ينطبق على محمد؟ Did this match Muhammad or Jesus? Jesus was sent to children of Israel. They were not pagans. They were not worshipping images. But Muhammad is the one who came for people who have pictured images. Okay? So the text in Isaiah is about a prophet who will fight pagans. And this matches Muhammad, does not match Jesus. Okay, let the waste land and its flocks be glad. The ten circles of Kedar. Kedar, 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 Kedar. Do you remember this name? Kedar is Quraysh, the son of Ismail. Let the people of the rock give a glad cry from the top of the mountains. Let them make a sound of joy. Okay, this is match Muhammad. Does not match any, nobody from Kedar except Muhammad. See the enemies of the Prophet? They will be turned back and be greatly shamed who put their hope in picture images, who say to metal images, you are our gods. وَأَمَّا الَّذِينَ يَعْبُدُونَ الْمُنْحُتَاتِ فَيَعْتَرِيهُمُ الْخِزِيِّ وَقُلْ جَاءَ الْحَقُّ وزهق الباطل إن الباطل كان زهوق. And the watchman gave a loud cry. Watchman الناطور الإنسان اللي يخبر الناس. Those who goes to a high place to tell people about the enemy who is coming. Al-Mundir, Al-Nadir. And the watchman gave a loud cry. وصاح المندر وصاح ليش الناطور. Oh my Lord, I am on the watch tower all day and I am placed in my watch every night. See here, come war carriages with men. Horsemen by Taos, and in answer he said, Babylon is made low, يعني سقطت بابل, and all her images are broken on the earth. Who took Babylon and who put down the images is Muhammad صلى الله عليه وسلم and his nation. The word about Arabia. يعني now دخلنا في الإيش في العميق. نبوءة عن جزيرة العرب. Okay. The burden upon Arabia. In the forest in Arabia shall you lodge oil, traveling companies of the Danube. يعني the انتوا عارفين انه you know that a lot of children of Israel were living near to Medina. That is Bani Nadir, Bani قينقاع, Bani قريضة and Khaybar. وادي القرى، اوكي، وفي تيمان. ف there is an advice for them, an order to them, that why they are there waiting for the prophet. And there is an order for them to believe in this prophet. See here, on the seat of David, seat of David, يعني عرش داود. عرش داود يعني مملكة داود. The kingdom of David. Seat of David is the kingdom of David. It will be taken by this prophet. Where is the kingdom of David? It's Palestine. Who took Palestine? Al-Islam. Okay, this is Badr. For so has the Lord said to me, in a year, by the years of a servant, يعني في سنة زي سنة الأجير، يعني سنة يعني سنة. Okay? Working for a payment, all the glory of Kedar will come to an end. And I told you that after Hijra, 1 year after Hijra, Quraysh have been defeated against Muhammad صلى الله عليه وسلم. This is the all the glory, كل مجد Kedar, Quraysh, will come to an end. And the rest of the bowmen, the men of war, of the children of Kedar, will be small in number. For the Lord, the God of Israel, has said it. ليش قال دائما يقول God of Israel? Okay? They change this. They don't want to mention the name of Allah as Allah رب العالمين. They don't want this. They want God to be for them. This is the attitude of the chosen people. Because they said God is for them. They are the chosen people. And we, the rest of people, we are the non-chosen people. And God created the non-chosen people to serve the chosen people. That's why now they are killing Palestinians in Palestine with a cold blood. Because they think that this is the order of God. Allah wants this. Just kill them. They are non-chosen people. Okay? If they think about this, whether they are chosen people, then why 10 tribes of them, nobody can find them now? 10 out of 12 chosen people. The 10 should be chosen ones. Where are they? If they are chosen, God will not make them to escape. Relax, they are not chosen. They're chosen because of religion. The righteous people are chosen. But the Jewish people, because they choose not to go in the way of Allah, they are cursed people. لُعِنَ الَّذِينَ كَفَرُوا بَنِي إِسْرَائِيلِ عَلَى لِسَانِ نَحْنَ عَلَى لِسَانِ دَاوُدُ عِيسَى بْنُ مَرْيَمَ أَنْبِيَاءَ. Okay, this is very nice text. There is a lot of text in Isaiah, a lot of it. I will give it all to you if you want. Let your voice be loud. أصرخ بصوت عالي. In song, بالأغاني. O women without children. Make melody, women without children. اللي هي إيش؟ هاجرة. ما عندها إلا إسماعيل بس. Make sounds of joy. You who did not give birth. For the children of her who had no husband are more than those of the married wife, says the Lord. يعني أبناء هاجر والمجد صار لهاجر أكثر مما صار لأبناء سارة. So now we talk about how many books till now?
Five.
Yeah, this is nice to see. This is This is Safanaya. Safanaya, chapter of Safanaya. There is one statement. It's a very small chapter. It's 2 pages. For then I will give the people a clean language, so that they may all make prayer to the Lord and be His servant with one mind. هل في أحد يعبد الله one mind one like Muslims? So now, how many books we have studied? Don't forget Zabanaya. We added one. So how many? Now, chapter or book of Song of the Psalms, then chapter of Daniel, then Genesis, then Deuteronomy, then Isaiah, اللي هو أشعياء باللغة العربية أشعياء, then صفنية اللي هو زفنايا. All they mention Muhammad صلى الله عليه وسلم or his nation. I will add one chapter before I go to the New Testament, that is the Injil. Habakkuk, a prophet, small, only 2 or 3 papers, that's all. Oh. God came from Timan. Timan means south, or Yemen. God came from Timan, and the Holy One from the Mount Paran. وجاء القديس من جبل من مكة. يعني خلاص. سيلا. This is a word that they repeated after a lot of phrases. The heavens were covered with His glory, and the earth was full of His praise. يعني there is a line there, I don't know how did it disappear. It mentioned that he will come with 10,000 people around his near to his right hand. That is the 10,000 sahaba during Fath Makkah. Okay. I think this is the New Testament. Okay. The New Testament, اللي هو العهد الجديد. Who is the first prophet in the New Testament? Everybody will say Jesus. صح؟ No, it's John Baptist. يحيى بن زكريا. John Baptist started 2 years earlier than Isa. This is true. This is true. And in those days, طبعاً, at that time, the time of John Baptist and Isa, Jesus, at that time, people were expecting the appearance of Isa, of Jesus. And they have prophecies about another man called Elijah, اللي هو الياسين. عندهم يعني, they think that he will come back. And about Muhammad. Some of them, they know, the scholars, they know that first will come Jesus. Then will come Muhammad. How did they know? I told you before that in the book of Daniel, the time of the appearance of Jesus was mentioned, the 70 weeks prophecy. The 70 week prophecy said exactly when Jesus is gonna to be a prophet. It was mentioned to them, they know it. So they were expecting, when, where? Khalas, this is time. This is the time for Jesus. Where is he? So John Baptist, Yahya ibn Zakaria started. Why they call them John? This is the Hebrew name of John, or the English name of Yahya. Baptist, what do we mean by the word Baptist? Baptist is Al-Ma'madan. What is Ma'madan? If you want to repent, tub, yani, you go to him. He will take some water and he wash you. He will give you a shower. This is called Ta'mid. This is the Baptist's work. He is baptizing you. So he was the one who was doing this, so they call him Al-Ma'madan. La Mushahab al-Istilah. John Baptist started. So the people came to him and asked him, who are you? Are you the Messiah who will come, Al-Masih al-Qadim? He said, no. He said, oh, are you Elijah that will come? He said, no. Oh, are you the Muhammad? Are you the prophet who will come? He said, no. Then they said, then who are you? There is no prophecy about you. He said, no, there is a prophecy, but you don't listen, you don't read, you don't understand. Who are you? He said, I'm the John Baptist. Was there any prophecy about you? He said, yes, go and read. Yeah? And he told them where to find it. Yes, there was. And in those days, John the Baptist came preaching in the wasteland of Judea. قام إيش يبشر في منطقة اليهودية جوديا saying let your hearts be changed from sin for the kingdom of heaven is near. The kingdom of heaven is اقترب موعد ظهور مملكة الرب. Do you remember the kingdom of heaven who first used this terminology? Daniel. Do you remember the stone that was thrown? This is. So he said, the kingdom of heaven is near. How do, when you ask Christians, you show them this text, هذا النص. How do they explain it? They will say, well, the kingdom of heaven is near. He mean Jesus. He mean يقصد عيسى. Okay? Now John was clothed in camel's hair with a leather band about him, and his food was locust and honey. Then يعني كان, he was يعني, a poor man, servant of God. Then Jerusalem and all Judea went out to him and all the people from near Judea. وجاءه الناس من اليهودية ومن حولها. What did he say to him? But when he saw a number of the Pharisees and Sadducees, those are the scholars. The problem of the Jewish people is their scholars. اللي هو الحخامات. لما شافهم, إيش قالوا? He said to them, coming to his baptism, he said to them, offspring of snakes, يا أبناء الأفاعي. He knows them. Offspring of snakes. At whose word are you going in flight from the wrath to come? يا أولاد ليش الأفاعي يا ويلكم من محمد إذا جاء حيبحكم. Whose word are you going in flight from the wrath to come? وفعلا محمد صلى الله عليه وسلم هو النبي ليش الملحمة. اها now Jesus supposed to be the kingdom of God according to them. يعني مفروض لما Jesus appear he should say what? I am the Christ. أنا المسيح. I am the kingdom of God. But see what he said. And Jesus went about in all Galilee, في الجليل, teaching in their synagogue, مساجدهم يسموها synagogue, and preaching the good news of the kingdom and making well those who were ill with any disease among the people. كان يعالج الناس من الأمراض, but what making, preaching the good news of the kingdom. So he is preaching, يبشر. Preaching means يبشر. So he is not the kingdom. He is not the kingdom of God. From that time, Jesus went about preaching and saying, let your hearts be turned from sin, for the kingdom of heaven is near. He said, he did not say the kingdom of heaven is me, or you are now living in the kingdom of heaven. He did not say that. They brought a crown and they want to put it in his head. The Israelites, is it time of prayer or what? The people want took a crown, they want to put it in his head and to say that he is the king. Okay, he refused and he escaped in the mountains. Who said? This book said. So he is not a king, he is not a kingdom, he is preaching the kingdom to come. And even now the axe is put to the root of the trees. جاء الفأس وضع الفأس على أصل الشجر. Every tree then which does not give good fruit is cut down and put into the fire. الشجرة التي لا تثمر جيدا تقطع وترمى في النار. So he described Israelites as a bad tree and he described Arab as a good tree and he said the bad tree now that I am the axe, أنا الفأس الذي سوف أقطعها. I'm sorry for this chapter. Psalms is part of the Old Testament. I don't know how this slide came to the New Testament, but I can always apologize. This is the Psalms, part a book of the Old Testament by David. هذا إحنا نسميها الزبور. الإسلام we call it زبور. They call it المزامير. Also we can call it المزامير in Islam, no problem, because there is hadith about this. Blessed, David said, مباركين are those who dwell in your house. الساكنين عند بيتك المعظم. They are ever praising you. Blessed are those whose strength is in you. مباركين الذي قوتهم فيك. Who have set their hearts on pilgrimage. الذين قلوبهم معلقة بالحج. As they pass through the valley of Baca. They make it a place of spring. The autumn rains also cover it with pools. So even Mecca mentioned by name. And do you know Baca? Mecca has two names. Baca and Mecca. Do you know why the name Baka? Because Ishmael Baka هناك, he cried. So it calls Baka, Buka. In other books, not like this one, the name Baka is not there, but they call it the Valley of Weeping. Mm-hmm. This name Baka is mentioned also in Quran. لَلَّذِي بِبَكَّ. ومكة أيضا also مكة is mentioned in Quran by the name مكة ببطني مكة. For this reason, I say to you, this is Jesus said in Matthew, the kingdom of God will be taken away from you and will be given to a nation producing the fruits of it. The rest of the lecture, inshallah, will be provided to you if you have flash memory. And if time allow in the future, inshallah, we can manage, inshallah, to complete the old, the text in the old and in the new testimony. It's very easy to prove to people who are seeking the truth. People who are not seeking the truth, whatever you prove to them, nothing. Even he is Muslim and living beside you and he saw Mecca and he doesn't want to listen, you cannot do anything to him. Even if you are Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam, and the one you want to guide him to guidance is your uncle, Abu Talib or Abu Lahab, you will not be able. Muhammad was not able to do this. You will not be able yourself. But he was able to spread the message to a lot of people far away from his place. And you will be able also to do the same. Of course. Before we conclude, as Dr. Abdullah said, one question from male side and one from female side, and then we conclude.
Dr. Abdullah, can we use this as evidence for them? Although it's not, as you mentioned, we're not sure about, is it the Torah or Anjil or something, it's Muharraf.
Our brother said, since we said about their book, it is falsified, can we use it as evidence against them? Yes. Because you ask them, is this falsified or true? They say, this is the God, what God said. See? Your book said this. If you believe that this book is right, you have to believe in this also. But to convince us, yani they bring some knowledge from it, to convince us, no, they don't have this right. But they have the right themselves to bring Quran. And if they will ask this, do you believe in Quran? We said yes. Anything in Quran, they can use it against us, but I cannot use it against them. Yani I go to one Christian, he said, well, this is Quran, and Quran said, "Inna dina inda Allah al-Islam." You say, wait a minute. I don't believe in Quran. This is not authentic. This is not what Muhammad, what Allah said. This is what Muhammad said. How can you use it against them? But if he said, yes, Quran is the word of God, then you can use it against them. But if he, from the start, he is denying Quran, cannot use it. The same thing, the issue, he said it's the word of God, this book, then you can use anything against him. He cannot use it against you, because you don't believe in it. This is the rules of dialogue. This is the rules of debate. Not because I'm Muslim, I'm using this. No, this is neutral. This is, everybody is using this. From the female side, well, they are giving it to our brother. Yes, brother.
You're talking to Christian about what Daniel said about that the kingdom of God will take control of Jerusalem till the end of the time. So he may say to you that the Crusaders took control of Jerusalem for about 2 centuries in history. So how can we?
Yeah, thank you very much. Yes, you reminded me about this. Yes, the Crusaders, Salibiyun, they ruled Jerusalem for 92 years. 92 years. 92 سنة. Al-Quds كانت as under the Crusaders. Yes, but there was no prayers there. Nobody was allowed to even themselves. They were not praying there. yes, this event has took place. If they said that, yes, but it, yani, do you remember the period 1260? Yeah. If you calculate from capture of Jerusalem by Umar ibn al-Khattab till 1948, that's 1984, when Israel is there, that is another 1260 sana, plus the 92 years of the Crusaders. Subhanallah. As the tariq can, we read nafsu, subhanallah. This is another issue, but yes, for 92 years, Jerusalem was not under the command of Muslims, but not most of Palestinians. يعني المنطقة كانت under the rule of Muslims for a trivial period. Yes, it was not. Yes. Thank you very much.